Looks like I have a new letter.
Eivor, out the gate.
I want to see the Alliance map. I have changed my mind. I should go.
Come on, I've got the good stuff.
Don't mind if I... along.
No casks here after all.
Hey, what nonsense is this? You don't have any ale, do you? Chicory, lies, deceit, bring it forth, I'm thirsty.
Come on, let's go drink.
I think so, too. Of course, there's nothing like a drilled hole in the head to fix one's ills. If it was good enough for the ancients, it's good enough for me.
Break you!
This place is heavily guarded.
Move along.
Eivor, news!
Your father's dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Humbjörn's house. I found the body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was struck. He cannot be gone. I am a man. Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son. Do not forget it.
Keep steady, Hunwald. You're now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain. Last in a line of dwindling nobles.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwald was the son of an Elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a Shiremut. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your Shiremut.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our Shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot. But between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
Hunwald is an obvious candidate, but I don't trust any of you beyond the tip of a spear. I'll see to it that he is protected until your Shiremut gathers.
None here wishes the boy ill. But do what you think necessary.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Elderman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this Shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire, and we'll convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word, if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my god commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Humbjörn's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow her.
The coming Shiremut, Bishop.
I would tell you my fate is in the hands of our Lord, but somehow...
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
What devil put you up to all this deception?
I wasn't put up, Eivor. I felt compelled to carry on for the good of the Shire. Until I knew the truth.
A pretty answer for an ugly lie.
I must beg forgiveness from my God. The Lord lifts up the meek. We must praise him.
Something I did not do!
Aid me. Be my eyes. Asked about this land, my friend.
These woods, Father. Oh, these woods. I remember the days we spent here together. Here, upon this spot. Ducking and hiding through the rushes, with bow and arrow, chasing rabbits and squirrels. 1,000 arrows I fired and 100 trees I bled. But not a single animal could I catch. All of them fled. Hello? Eivor? Is that you? Eivor, what a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald.
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate. Contemplate.
Let's have a drink, to the memory of your father.
Here we go, we're sailing among the leaves so green.
Do not go on grief, nor give in to sadness, but let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting. And I would catch the most wretched little things, if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. He always said he was proud. Each and every time.
I told your father, Lord Hund of Lincolnshire, he may have dwindled from this world.
It's the right! Oh, Barrow loves that one. My lady love. Father would have liked her.
Your Dane lady love. She sounds lovely.
No.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You've never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound? Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter? Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You can't grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect her. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced, but I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be a poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course, but give me that chance. God, I just need to have that chance.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor. Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Quiet. Stop here. Something isn't right. I'll find the trouble before it finds us.
Eivor, I am sweating from pit to toe. Do not leave me here.
Hush. Stay calm.
What?
Rock Eivor!
I'm over here!
That's twice they've tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck. Be careful, they will succeed. Someone in...
Come, let us hurry away!
I'm serious, Hunwald.
Here I am with a chance to be... To you, to the Shire, to...
Her!
I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
Thank the heavens! There she is!
Hundval! I thought for sure you'd be dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilt it without you, but still I grow. And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your Shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A Shire moot will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here, out of sight, until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love?
Here with you.
Hunwald, this Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
A strength you lack, you have in Swanborough.
It's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I don't doubt it. looking for someone?
My husband. He was not supposed to leave home on his own. I fear he has fallen asleep somewhere.
Fallen asleep?
Yes, a curse he has carried his whole life. At any moment, his eyes roll back and his body simply collapses.
Dangerous to be out there on his own. Do you think he would have gotten far?
His bag is gone. I fear he may have taken it to go fruit picking down south near the old ruins. Pjarti, where are you?
I will keep an eye out for him.
Thank you.
He snores, if that helps.
Follow my voice, Pjarti!
You killed him! Die!
Interesting.